Hello, it's Darren Epic. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be discussing and diving a little deeper into the home buying process and strategy for current buyers and future buyers in the Los Angeles market in 2021. This will help them understand what it will take to buy a home in this market. It is very much so a seller's market still, with multiple bids always happening on properties, especially single family homes. So we'd like to prepare you for that. If you like the content you see today, please like my channel. If you want to see more content like that, please subscribe. Comment below and let me know what the kind of content you want to see. I make this content every week for you guys, and here we go. First, before I start with the home buying process, I like to kind of give you an idea of what market we're in right now and what it's been doing. In June 2021, LA County saw home median price go up to 23.1%, up to $790,000. Like I said, this is a 23.1% increase. Year over year, from June 2020 to June 2021, that's a 68.9% increase. And the thing is right now it's a seller's market. Many experts say they don't see it slowing down. Inventory is still an issue. And so if you speak to lenders, some of the smart ones will tell you that if you wait longer, just because you're thinking about saving down for a down payment, you may want to consider the fact that the home values are going up and rates could go up as well. So you may end up paying more later instead of just trying to start the process now and maybe find something in the next 2 months instead of waiting 2 months and then finding something in 4 months. So just some food for thought. Moving on to the first key area in the home buying process and strategy to buy a home. Number one, you have to consult with a preferred lender. This is the beginning step. I mean, you have to basically figure out if you can get pre-approved and what your budget is, and they'll go through with you and discuss financials. So you have an idea of, you know, what you can afford based on financials, income statements, tax returns, etc. So this is the first step. You can go to open houses and get an idea of what homes are out there like, but you have to get, you know, speak to a lender and figure out one that works for you, one that you gel with, and get pre-approved. So first you need to, you know, maybe talk to one or two preferred lenders. I can refer you a few, maybe have a friend refer you one, and then you go from there. And in my experience so far, most of my clients have liked the first referral I give them and they go from there. Then I have another person I can refer them, but you know, it's just a lot of times easier for them, and they click, they go forward, and they get the ball rolling. So then they'll give you an idea of your budget. Then we can figure out what we can start looking for, if those areas that we already know you love and the type of, you know, expectations and the boxes you need to check off are even applicable. So it's like, you may think you can afford a $1.5 million home, but you find out you can only afford a $1 million property. That's a big difference. Or even 1 million to 800,000. It's a big difference. Then we need to know this information. Then also, you know, I work really closely with these lenders through the process. We kind of, you know, depending on the person, some of us have more experience together. We're a team. We're here to support you and help you accomplish your goals. So I do like to be in touch with the lender from the get-go once you've chosen one. And I like to know what's going on from the get-go as well, so I can have an idea of where we're at. So I'm usually very hands-on with the lender, and it helps me to help you, you know, achieve your goals. Then also kind of like a food for thought, when you're looking for a good lender, I know rate's really important to people, but also if you feel like someone's going to service you better and they're really going to be around and they're going to help you through the process, I highly recommend that you look at all angles. You look at, you know, someone that's going to give you a great rate, but also they're going to be great servicing the process, because a good lender can make or break a deal sometimes, especially in escrow. Recently had this issue where this lender was a great rate, but pretty bad at communication, giving us misinformation between the buyers and different departments talking to each other internally at their company. So, you know, we were late on our loan contingency and, you know, could have lost the property and fell out of escrow. I mean, luckily the agent was really cool and I was very much in touch with them, but it was kind of a stressful situation. So you need to think about that. Someone that can close and get the loan, you know, completed on time or early. So those are things to think about. And then Also, food for thought, a lot of lenders, a lot of realtors will talk about the 20% down payment and how it's very misleading. Many people over the years think they need 20% down. It's preference. It can help you get a bigger budget. It can help you be more competitive. But I can tell you from experience, a lot of my clients have not done, 20%. Majority have done 10%. And even one did FHA 3.5%. If you're looking to do $1 million property, I definitely do recommend you do 10% or more, depending on the value of the property or the budget you want to go after. But you don't have to do 20%. It's up to you, but it's like, I'm just trying to it's almost like pull that thought process away and help you understand, because the budgets could go up, the home values could go up like they're supposed to. If they keep going up, you waiting for 20% could cost you money overall, as well as rates wise. Just depends on what the rates are doing. So hope that gives you understanding. Number two, getting pre-approved. Probably besides meeting a lender, the most important step, because if you don't get pre-approved, you can't put any offers in. Today, some people aren't even in LA letting agents set up appointments for buyers unless they share a pre-approval letter and a proof of funds or POF. So if you're not pre-approved and you don't have the proof of funds, sometimes you're not even able to see places unless they've done open houses. Basically, agents, listing and buyer's agents don't want people wasting their time. So you need to get pre-approved. It shows you're serious. So this is the second step, getting pre-approved. A lender helps you do that. It gives you an idea of what your max amount is. So that way you can look at $1 million property if you're pre-approved for 1.1. You can look at a $990,000 property if you're pre-approved for it. Also, your pre-approval amount shares with the agent, whether you know it or not, what's the max you can do. So sometimes, if you're shooting too high, they know that you may not be able to compete with other buyers. So it's very important. Also, the pre-approval letter gives me an idea what your budget is, obviously, so we can shop for the right areas and check off the right boxes. If you think you're gonna buy a place for $1.5 million before you're pre-approved, and I start showing you places or you're looking at those, and then you find out your budget's only $1 million, it's very different of what you can and cannot buy, how big of size, bedrooms, bathrooms, yard, lot size, aesthetic, everything. It just makes a world of a difference. $100,000 makes a difference. So we need to know what you're pre-approved for. So that's the number two step, one of the most important steps. Number three, monthly budget. This is something a lender can help you with. I bring this up because I want prospective buyers, future buyers, and current buyers to keep this number in mind. We both, you guys as a, husband, wife, single female, single male, family, etc. You all have a monthly number that you're trying to accomplish. Maybe you want to be conservative and you only want to spend a certain amount a month. So I always recommend to future buyers, clients, prospective buyers, current buyers, that you really consider your monthly budget so you buy what you're comfortable with. Perfect example is for me, years ago when I bought when I was 28, back in Phoenix, I bought and I could afford a lot more. And I said I wanted to spend only a certain amount because I wanted to spend a certain amount monthly budget. That was just for me. That's just what I wanted to do. So I always think of my clients as if it was me. So I think you should definitely consider your monthly budget when you're buying a home. Do what you're comfortable with and just always keep it in mind. Obviously things change during the process, but do yourself a favor and just try to keep that in mind. Number four, consult with a real estate agent. A lot of times if you're already in this process, spoke to a lender, getting pre-approved, you're consulting with a real estate agent. What we need from you is to understand your goals. If this is a first-time home, is it a starter home? Is it a 10-year home? Is it a forever home? We need to understand your locations, your boxes that need to be checked off. Obviously, you need to understand what your budget is, what you're comfortable with spending. What would be the max you would spend? Is there, hey, Darren, we actually can afford more of this if we need to, if we see the right home. Anything and everything. I need to know as much information as possible so I'm on your team helping you find what it is you want. I'm trying to help you accomplish your goals, which is buying a property. A lot of times people are doing it for an investment, especially right now. They want it to appreciate. So I want to help share with you also my thoughts and information on the marketplace and where there are areas for opportunity. So consulting with a real estate agent is a very important part. By this time, you probably already have, but I really think it's very important. We need to know the boxes that need to be checked off. We're here to help you out. The more information you give us, the better. Number five, seeing homes. It's pretty straightforward. You need to see properties. You can have an idea in your head and you can have certain boxes that need to be checked off. Obviously, like, you know, you have, you know, a couple and they have, you know, two kids, they definitely need at least three rooms. If they need an office, they need four rooms or a workspace. There's certain things that can shift though. Maybe a yard's really important, but maybe a pool was important in the beginning and maybe it changed. So you need to see homes. So A, you get an idea of a feel of what your budget can get you. Then also you need to maybe have, maybe there's not just one area that you need to focus on. Maybe there's other areas that you didn't know about that I can provide you or a realtor can provide you that gives you, that checks up all the boxes. So I'll talk into that a little bit about being flexible, but seeing homes allows you to gauge what you like and dislike. And maybe you'll see over the course of the time of you seeing properties, because you'll start getting a feel like we do, because we see so many properties as a realtor. You get a feel for really what works. Certain streets, certain, you know, privacy, certain little things. And if you don't see properties and you're just going off of Zillow or what you think in your head, a lot of times by seeing properties, you'll kind of fine tune the home that you think is perfect for you at the time, whether it's a starter home, a 10-year home, or a forever home. These things will change while you're seeing homes. So it just, all it does is really educate you and help you guide you. And then the realtor obviously helps you as well. But I always tell people, please do it. It's only gonna help you in the process. It'll also get you a gauge on what things cost. So you can get a feel for this area might be out of our price range, or maybe this is not gonna ever have what we need. Maybe there's something similar to it in another neighborhood or another area of LA. So highly encourage people to see homes. It's only gonna help you understand, it's only gonna help you see the home and buy the home that you love, because you'll know when you see it after seeing like 10 plus homes. When I bought in 2009, I probably saw at least 30, it might have been 50 homes in Phoenix. And I know my realtor was probably like, I hate you, but she was okay with it. We would try to see as many in a chunk when I could go. And then I knew when I saw the property I wanted and I bought it and I put an offer right away. So I think it can only help you. And also if you're on the fence about a property, you think you might like it or like it enough and you decide not to see it, I think you should probably see it because you might be surprised. A lot of times people are surprised by the property that they end up putting an offer on. Number six, be patient and flexible. Patience is a virtue. When you're shopping for a home in LA, and usually in LA it's competitive anyways, but now it's really competitive with this current seller's market in 2021, with multiple offer situations that you've heard of, you need to be patient because it takes time to find the home that, you know, checks off a lot of the boxes. And then in terms of being flexible, you have to be flexible because you may not find a home that checks off five boxes. It only checks off three, but those three boxes are great. If you had an unlimited budget even, you may not always find the home that checks off all the boxes, even if you had a lot of money. You can also buy a home that you love and then have to make changes later because after living in it, you change your mind. You know, I'm just trying to tell you that, you know, if you think you're gonna find like this perfect home, good for you if you do. But a lot of people find things that they could change and improve or alter after they even found the home that they love. So be patient and flexible. It is a process, especially in today's market. Number seven, be ready to win. If you love a home, you've been through the process, you've been thinking about buying a home for a while, you are pre-approved, you have a budget in mind, you can afford a certain amount, you can even maybe increase, you love this home. Right now, are you gonna let, I've seen it, $10,000, $15,000, $20,000 come in the way of you winning the property that you know you love and that you want? I say go for it. You should have the right person steering you, guiding you, a good agent, a good lender. You know, we've done this pretty well with our clients this year, winning in multiple offer situations, and even last year as well. And it's really a strategy in terms of helping you win with a certain price point, knowing kind of gauging what other people might have bidded and feeling out, you know, working with the agents to communicate to kind of understand where everyone else is coming in. They can only give you so much information, but I can tell you, if you love a property, go for it, win it, and, you know, work well. And you know, be, if you're not comfortable with, you know, going all in, let's say your budget's $1 million max and the place is at 950, I mean, go at 975 or 980 if you think that'll win the property, but really listen to your lender and your agent, because they're getting as much information and they're not as emotionally attached and in the whirlwind that you are. I would say that's a good piece of advice, because you're gonna be so wrapped up and you're not gonna hear things sometimes. I've noticed that buyers sometimes in the moment, they get caught up, whereas the agent's just thinking about what can we do to help with the lender to help them win this property. So I would say, as if you want to win, just really strongly suggest that you listen to your agent. That's all I have to say about that. To recap, we covered 7 key areas that are part of the home buying process and strategy when buying a home in Los Angeles in 2021, and for the most part, moving forward. Number one, you gotta consult with a preferred lender. Number two, you need to get pre-approved, because that is the budget you know that you have to buy a home. Number three, you need to, you know, kind of configure your monthly budget, because that's what you'll be comfortable with paying monthly for the home that you buy. And you can talk to your lender and agent about that as well. Number four, you should consult with a real estate agent. Number five, you need to see properties, you need to see homes, you need to see them in person. Open houses will help you. If right now a lot of things are appointment-based too, you need to see properties. If you're not, you're not gonna buy a place, because you're not, you don't know what the pros and cons are, and you're not like shape-shifting what the property that you want is. This is very important. You need to see homes, you need to see properties, you need to drive around neighborhoods. I mean, these are things you have to do. You need to be patient and flexible. And then number seven, last but most importantly as well, in today's market, you need to be ready to win. The only way you can achieve these things in today's market is by having a smart, really solid realtor, and you need a great team overall. You need a great lender as well. Too many times people have, you know, they can work with realtors that maybe aren't as solid as others or don't have the support, and they're losing opportunities left and right. Maybe they're not as good with a certain price point, or maybe they're used to doing super high end luxury, which I've met with some people before about this, or they're used to doing only like, you know, lower end inventory, or only know certain areas. Just gotta be really smart about who you pick to trust and help you guide you through the process, because that's how you're gonna win and get the property you love. And also having a great lender, like I said, they can make a huge difference, especially in escrow and also with your pre-approval and getting your budget. I mean, some lenders have more flexibility. They can have higher price points for you, whereas, you know, cookie cutter banks, actually, honestly, they have so many boxes that need to be checked off. They're not as creative. So these things are really important. I hope you learned a lot in this video. I hope this shed some light on the process and home buying process, as well as strategy to buy a home in Los Angeles. This stuff is applicable to future years, you know, other markets, pretty much down to the basics. But if you like the video you saw today, please like my video. If you want to see more content like this, subscribe to my channel. My name's Darren Epic. If you have any videos you want to see in the future, please leave some comments. Love to hear your feedback, as I do these videos every week for you guys at home. Thank you very much. Have a great day.